something at that particular time. Mm-hmm. You're not talking about the lyrics, you're not talking about the song. It's just humming something for you. That's what it is for your spirit. You know? But in my bed with me. You see people enjoying music like this? Their souls are really enjoying the music. So for me, when you're enjoying music and you're dancing, it's like full package. That's what it is. And I feel like that's what really gave Mr. Drew the light. Do you understand? And I can't really tell his story for him, but that's what I see whenever he's dancing. You can really see that his body's really connecting with the lyrics and the melody and everything. And these are the dances that stand out.
I think maybe with the dancing, we don't know you for dancing like the vocals, but today we will dance with you.
I don't need to. I mean, we will dance, right?
Yeah.
You don't need to be the best dancer. What it just means is just dance and let your body connect with the music. And that's just what it is.
Today we will dance with Camido.
Yeah.
Wait, is that what you were trying to preach about with a Dance With Me song? Or you were getting some lover to dance with you? Yeah. Or what really? Let's talk about
Well, that song I was basically making, I made it having a wedding in my mind. You know, it's like basically it's toasting a girl and she's playing hard to get. But, you know, last, it's like, you know what? Oh, yeah, bro. Yes. You know what I mean? And then she comes in and then she finally enjoys the dance. It's like, ooh. And yeah, no. Like, you know, is that finally you're dancing with me and all of that. So that's what it means. Basically just talking about me loving you and don't be shy. You know, I got it. Everything that you're looking for, I got it. Just come closer. And then, you know, so that's just what came into my mind when I was making the music. I spoke to the team and everyone I heard the music even before it was released said they had a feeling of wedding. They had a setting of wedding in their mind. Wedding setting. And then we just spoke to Norbert Datsun. He was able to, you know, come on board and help us, you know, translate the whole music into like the visualization. Yo. He did a great job, brought the vendors. We really did a full wedding. That was the idea.
No.
Other people would have just gone to storm another wedding and then shot from there. But we just, like, we really put in work in this music video. Yeah, we did a full music video, which was like a full wedding. I got married, you know what I'm saying? And I actually connected with the lady as though we were getting married. So okay. This is what a job called for, and this is what we did. And so I feel like it's time for all the couples, every wedding couple, everyone about to get married. This is the song that you need to jam to because it has no vocal words. It's the melodies really like appeal to the wedding setting. Everyone, you know, even the flowers, the decor goes with the song.
Yeah.
You know, so it is the song that I purposely made for the wedding industry. And I don't see no reason why you have your wedding and then the wedding song that God himself sent to earth for you to dance with in this millennium, in this like century, you will not play this music in your wedding. It'd be like, say, your wedding, you won't make it last for just like. So, I mean, this is a song for them. And, you know, I would really be touched to see a lot more wedding videos, people jam into this music. And I want to, like, it's a thing that we're doing, like, every weekend. We do like about 4 or 5 weddings. Like I just go into the weddings and just bless them with the music, perform for them, happy with them, bless them with, you know, my voice. And
that's nice.
Yeah.
The way you speak of bless them with it, spirits, God give me.
Yeah.
Do you see yourself as a vessel that you're being used to do this? Like, do you see yourself as a man of God? I mean, people think that if you sing hallelujah, it's the way you keep saying it, I want to mention this man's name. He does this old singer. Oh, Ashes' artist. Mm. Yeah, I've forgotten his name. He has a team, T.Y. and the Asomafo. Yao Sapon. Oh, thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Mm. Yao Sapon speaks of an artist seeing himself as manifesting the love side, whichever side the Lord wants to portray. Do you see yourself in that light too?
I feel like you don't need to see yourself, you're already a vessel. You know, you didn't bring yourself to F. You know what I'm saying? You didn't create yourself. So you don't need to even be like, I see myself. Now, everyone is a vessel.
Okay.
Everyone is playing a role.
But some vessels, the devil is using
nah,
it for.
Now, everyone is God's vessel. Listen, if God does not approve of something, there's no way you'll be able to do it. I feel like people, like, that's what I believe in.
Okay.
I feel like it is the will of God that made you walk from here to here. Other than that, you're just like, if God's will was done, you'd have dropped dead. It was actually the will of God for Eve to come and tell Adam to go in. Who else was going to make it happen? Do you understand? Everything that he created, he saw that it was good. He knew. He gave everything purpose. So everything, somebody robbing, doing everything. Why? I don't want to, you know. So everyone is a vessel. I don't want to go so deep, you know. Yeah. Because if I do like that, I will just start the prophesying and I don't want to talk something.
Let's talk about the creation of Dance With You.
Right.
Did it take like a 1 hour for you to stand to, you know, put the lyrics together because you already had what you wanted to say in mind? Or it was that thing that you needed different inspiration? Because, I mean, the various aspects of weddings that comes together to make that beautiful thing, they are so diverse, different things. Did you need to tap inspiration from the various parts of it to be able to make one masterpiece, or it just came?
I'm not the artist that does that. I'm not the artist that I go with my spirit. Unless, of course, I feel like I don't have enough inspiration to make the song, I will not even sit down to start making a song. Okay. Once I start, that means that I have it. It's there. So I just need to, like, you know, pick the right words and languages and all that to be able to express what the spirit is telling me. I'm not the artist that I'm singing and then I'm thinking about, hey, will this thing appeal to, okay, weddings, what are, hey, flowers. Like, I'm not the artist that, when you do that, then it's like, you are trying to create something your own self, like the body's trying to create something. But for me, I just let my spirit create music. So sometimes, you know, there are some songs that, for example, when Stoneboy made Putu, like, you didn't have to, it was just the melodies that were speaking to everybody and making everybody dance and sing the music. Am I lying?
Yeah.
You know, so I'm not that.
No.
So, yeah. You know, so I'm not the artist that does that. No, I'm not. Unless it's a project that's like fixed. It's like, okay, we want you to make, it's like a contract. It's like, we want you to make a song about Olulu Express. We want you to make a song about Agua Wine. Okay, we use this, these are the ingredients. So then you have to play by the rules. Okay. Do you understand?
Okay.
But if I decide to make music for the world, who are you to come and tell me that? Like, it's not your spirit. If it's your spirit, then come and then we'll do contracts. Do you understand?
Yeah. Yeah.
So, like, I'm just the artist that allows my spirit to just, unless I finish and then me myself, I feel like now I want to change something or my spirit is telling me to change it. Or the people that I listen to, you know, the people dear to, like, the people that I feel like understand, connect to my spirit. When they speak, it's easy for me to like agree with and then fix or change some things in my music. Yeah.
Okay, and who produced the song?
Dance With You. I produced it, basically. I produced it. I had some help. Big shout outs to Mark of the Characters band. He played the bass.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, I had the whole idea. I made the basic production and everything, but I had to replace some of the stuff with some live instruments. So Neptune was my in-house producer. He added some saxophone and some lead guitars and all of that. Yeah.
Those instruments, do they trigger another realm of your spirituality when you have to put lyrics on it? Because I know if a bass guitar should be, it hits a chord in your, it's like a chord touches a chord.
Yeah.
Do you get that when you have to record a song? Like, do you get that?
Yeah. For example, let me see. You know when you eat artificial rice, you know, or let's just say,
please,
you know,
I have it.
You've not had it before, but like, you know, things that, let's say, you rather go for one.
Yeah.
You can wait. Okay, for example, there are some colas. We have Coca-Cola, right? And there's some other colas that cannot beat Coca-Cola. Do you know what I'm saying? It's like, you've had that's the first time you've ever tasted cola, a cola drink. So it's like, when the other ones or some other ones came, you feel like, nah, this is, you prefer Coca-Cola to them other ones, right? No disrespect to any other brand, but that's what I'm trying to say.
I get it.
So it's like, this was the original thing. Would you rather go for?
I get
you. You see, that's what it is, yeah. Yeah, for me, that's what it is for me. Yeah.
Okay, so, since you got your inspiration for the Dance With For You or Dance With You, was it difficult interpreting those things into visual forms for the director to shoot the video?
Nah, like I said, everyone that heard the music even before it came out, like once I finished, everyone that heard it said wedding. okay. Even me myself, like I was preaching wedding. So when they now said wedding, I'm like, okay, you people, the spirit is coming through.
But
you.
The details of the wedding, the details.
That one is for like the team.
Okay.
Basically, my team said, okay, we want it. First of all, it was gonna be somebody else getting married and then me surprising their wedding. You know. Then the team said, you know what? Let him get married. Let him be the one to get married.
I want to ask you.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So that one has to do with because I trust certain people in my team to interpret my music into visuals, you know. So I just left it for them. That's not my field.
Okay. The reason I'm asking about if it was your
idea.
There are types of weddings.
Right.
What you did was the luxurious, you know.
Type of.
Is that your kind of wedding? That's you? Because then me, if you tell me wedding, if I write from the Holy Spirit and I have to do, I see very simple wedding.
Yeah.
Is that the kind of wedding you would want to have? That's because according to you, it's their spirit was in line with your spirit, which means that they think you would like such a wedding.
Mm.
Is that the kind of wedding you would go for if you had a chance to?
Not necessarily the type of wedding that I would go for. That's not my ideal type of wedding. But the thing is, I'm making music. I'm making a product, not for just myself, but okay. for the world. So that's like commercial. So at the end of the day, we look at what the people are really going for these days. What are they really going for? That's the type of wedding that they're going for. So we have to express what they would love to buy. You know, after making the music with my spirit, the rest is a product. So we have to now brand it in a way that
you have everyone, to brand their spirit.
Thank you. We brand it in a way that everyone will buy it.
Okay.
Now, how would you feel if somebody comes to you and says that he or she is a man of God? And the person is smelling like, it's like typically a mad person telling you something. And then another person also dressed in suit and then also telling you the same thing. Do you understand?
Yeah.
You will prefer like the person dressed well because it's like the spirit is a clean spirit.
Mm-hmm.
So you brand it in a way that the world would, you know, would appeal to the wedding industry. And then we'll make them want to like, you know, have you to perform and have you to play the music video and all of that, watching over and over again. So it's basically business. And then we were just doing marketing from there.
Okay. And how is the market faring?
Very, very, very well. I feel like we're doing, we're progressing. Yeah. Like 60 out of 100. We're climbing still. Yeah. It's one of the reasons why we're here, you know, because when Tilly speaks to you, ha, ha, ha. When Tilly speaks to you, that's direct success, man. You know.
I'm humbled. Yeah. Okay, so I think we have to touch on the album. You've been talking about it so much.
Yeah.
I mean, you've been subtly saying, Tilly, let's talk about the album. Let's talk about it.
Yeah.
What about it?
I mean, it's called Lighter. L-I-T-A. Basically means love is the answer. And the inspiration behind it is from my life story. Everything that I have achieved all my life came through love, the power of love. People have shown me so much love. I feel like God's favor found me and through people, you know, showing me love in all dimensions of my life, all areas of my life. It's just been love. And so I thought that love was really my answer to everything. And I decided to call it Love is the Answer, which is Lighter in short. Just like we did a contingency plan and called it CP. You know, so that's what it's called. And as of now, it's looking like we're going to have 14 tracks on it.
Oh, cool.
And I have amazing, very amazing features from very amazing artists like the Queen Amare.
Woo! I'm hyped.
The Queen Amare and God MC Manifest. Ooh. Thank you so much for the love. We have Nana Fofie,
okay.
Amazing songstress.
Oh,
amazing songstress, wow. You know, endorsed by the Queen, Nicki Minaj. And not just because of the endorsement, but she is an awesome vocalist. I particularly went in to call her to say, yo, we need to do this. And, you know, she was already like, you know, she listened to my music and she, you know, she went back and said, you know what, let's do it. You know, so. We was on the phone and over FaceTime making the music and all of that. It was fun. Of course, some more that, you know, will unveil themselves when their track list and all of that comes up. I'm really excited about this album. I'm still like switching some of the tracks. I'm still like polishing some of the tracks. I know for a fact and I believe it that it's really gonna stay.
Perspectives.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
When you went to the UK,
right?
Did they give you a different look of some of the projects on the album for you to retouch some of them? I mean, today we always spoken about the Ghana Party in the Park and
yeah,
all,
yeah.
But you know,
yeah.
another time. Yeah. did it change your perspective?
Yeah. I mean, it did. Not change, but kind of like improved.
Okay.
You know, because I felt like, listen, I want to become a world artist. I don't just want to be like an artist that will do like shows Ghana all my life. Like, I want to go out there and perform, even to crowds that people that I don't know. You know, I want to be on tour. I want to, like, I just want to be a global icon, yeah? Because of the inspiration I had from Akon. And also, when I traveled, I've been in a session with Weston, Kain Ketty of King Promise. Big shout-outs to King Promise. Shout-outs to you, Onukba. You know, he invited me to his sessions with all of them, like, artists. And I listened to their sounds, and I listened, and I, you know, learned a lot from the conversations that we had. Realized that, listen, it's about time that we stop letting people sit on our minds, like, you know, or control our minds, like, say, you know, hey, do this or don't do this or don't do this, like, express yourself, like, be an artist, you know, make music for the world and music that everybody would love, you know. You're free to make dance music, you're free to do, like, you know, balongo, whatever it is, but just brand it and, you know, present it in a way that the world would accept. And that's what I've learned, and that's what we're doing, you know. And I'm actually supposed to go back to do some work with some artists, you know. And I also believe, and I also learned the fact that we don't just record when you want to make an album.
Okay.
We are here as artists, you know, and it's not only, I mean, you don't only have to wait for the time to come and then you say you start recording. Once, anytime you're having a spirit, collaborate with people. Collaborate. Like, once you feel like this is the guy I want to reach out, let's be in a session and stop doing, let's reduce the send over the track. Let's be in a session together. Let's connect.
The two spirits meet.
Thank you. You know, that helps a lot as well. So these are some of the things that I learned, you know, and I feel like Ghana, we're ready. We're really ready. And myself, I feel like I'm ready.
I think you are.
Yeah.
Let's just end the conversation with this. When you stepped on the Ghana party in the park stage,
yeah,
and then you got the response that you got, did you feel like our songs doesn't travel, or you felt like, nah, it travels, we are not hearing the true story?
I feel like the music is traveling. The artists need to be on road, you know? We need to be on road, like, enough of just staying home and just doing IG live and saying silly stuff. And, you know, just doing things that, I mean, lack of traveling is making us do, or lack of, you know, being
exposure.
An artist. Yeah, it's not really, I mean, I feel like once you feel like you're an artist, you don't really, you know, the reason for touring is taking your music to the other parts of the world. That's what it means to tour. It's, you don't really have to sit down for a promoter to call you and say, you know, your music is banging. You can reach out to the promoters. Yo, I want to go on tour in these areas. You know, 50-50. Let's see how best we can play that out. Like, I feel like Ghanaian artists, most of us have to start going on tour. You know, we have to start liaising, you know, lobbying with the promoters and start doing our shows. Like, we don't just have to sit for five artists to just do their shows at the end of the year. Let's find a ways of, you know, that is why we're here. Do you understand? That is our job. So we have to go. That's some of the things I've learned. And I feel like my colleagues need to be out there to see how it's done. And I feel like it will change our perspective generally. And also how, you know, I didn't mean to disrespect nobody by saying going on IG Live and saying silly stuff. What I meant was that, you know, we will stop doing unnecessary stuff. Some of the unnecessary stuff that we do, because we have nothing on our hands. You know what I'm saying? Like, as an artist, there's so much that we can do that we don't do and we don't even tap into. And so it makes us, like, idle sometimes. And then we just sit down and just...
Congratulations.
Thank you so much. And I also want to say congratulations. Like, I just told you even before the interview began, I feel like you're so bold. You know, for a lady... I watch some of the, you know... videos, like, cuts of the videos that... I mean, when you are on, like, the panels... talking, and I feel like you really speak positive, and I feel like you're really bold. That's really great, and for a lady of your, you know, caliber doing that, it's really good, and I want to commend you on that.
I know there's somebody on your album somewhere, because I heard.
Yeah. King Sag has always been an inspiration,
and he loves you, I must say.
Yeah, and I love him more. Like, I feel like I love him more. You know, I feel like I love him more, but, you know, like, the industry, like, when I was coming up, has not been, like, easy for me. So it's like, sometimes you don't over get a chance to express how much you love some artists. You're, like, really trying to build yourself and all of that. But I really thank God that I had the chance to meet him, because one of the the things that really blessed me or made me feel blessed when I traveled was when I met Zach, you know, because I learned a lot from him, even in his session. His composure, his work ethic was really great. I really like enjoyed it. And on top, he blessed me with a verse. That was crazy. Look, listen, when he told me he loved the song that I played for him, I wasn't really waiting for a verse. It's like, now I understand when Stormzy said that he was in a room with Jay-Z and he was like, Jay-Z wanted to write a verse and he was like, nah, I don't think it's time yet. Like, please don't do it. That's how I felt. Oh. I was like, I'm already blessed. I'm already inspired. Do you understand? It's like, I wasn't waiting for the verse. I'm like, guy, I'm charged. Like, I'm charged. I'm coming back to Ghana to do a lot of work. Like, you know, because it also feels great when your mentor shows you love and also sees that you are learning from them and also pushing. It makes them proud of showing you that love.
Wait, he's your mentor? He's a rap artist.
I'll play you a song. I'll actually give you a song now that I made 13 years ago when me and an artist called Hector, he's... mentor was Edem and my mentor was Sarkode, and we made that song just talking about our mentors.
Is there a video to it?
There's no video to it, but I'll play you the song.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll play you the song and you will understand that Sarkode actually made me rap. Ooh. I started rapping because of King Sark. Yeah. I was a rapper, I was a writer, I was in sessions with Irene Logan, I was in sessions with Kofi B. I was doing up, you know, on a come up. But I feel like all of these things came together to help me build.
I don't understand how you were a better singer, because then you have learned over the years to minimize words, a lot of words, to make it simple, and then congratulations, as I said. And
thank you.
I mean, the world is yet to see more of you, because then so far, I think so very good.
Thank you so much.
You are really, really doing well. And when the EP comes, the album, please, the listening, invite me.
Definitely.
Let me come and stand there and show body.
I've already learned from King Sark. Like, you people, you wait and you see the listening sessions that we're going to
have. One Play Africa, we can organize it for you. Thank you so much, Camido, for coming on here. And I really appreciate your presence. Thank you so much. You see why I love him. The green hair alone kills me.